Just so you're aware, St. Martin will be home on the scoreboard today, and La Salette will be the visitor. Again, St. Martin will be home, La Salette will be the visitor. Also, any of the players, coaches, parents, and supporters, we are going to have Mass today, somewhere between 5:30 and 5:45, depending upon the end of the games. That will be inside the St. Louis University High School Chapel, and you are all welcome. We will have palms for that celebration as we move into Palm Sunday. Thank you. Looks like St. Martin will be kicking off to La Salette. St. Martin in the black jerseys and La Salette in the stripe. Nice deep kick into the centers. Fielded by number 12. Last Salette eight man takes it into the ruck, then to the lock number 5. Referee stops for the removal of a chain. With the official stoppage in play, we're going to go to a scrum for La Salette, who was in possession at that ruck when time was called. Clean hook by La Salette. Oh, number 9 with a slick little turnaround move. It looks like there was a potential knock on there, yes, knock on in the exchange, and so we'll have a scrum down for St. Martin. Take on short side. Out to number 2 for St. Martin. We have a knock on right in the try zone. That'll be a free kick. Little grubber ball right into the hands of prop number 3. Offloads to 7. Still have St. Martin in an advantageous position here inside the 22. Little bit of some bobbling going on. We have the serve playing advantage. Probably see La Salette give it a kick here. High kick out to the 30. The bounce. Lucky bounce for La Salette, but unfortunately, right, standing right on the line, it'll be a line out to St. Martin. But nonetheless, La Salette gains some breathing room as it comes out to the 48-yard line. And remember, for those new to rugby in the lineup, there has to be a specified distance between two teams. And the defensive team must match the jumpers, the number of jumpers. He'll call that for not straight. Usually if you see the outside arm being utilized in the catch or the attempt to catch, you'll get a not straight call from the serve. Scrum down, Lasalle. Inside cracks in the centers to the forward pod with the number five. Back to the forward pod again, this time to number one, the prop. Three phases to the forwards in the pods, that was the number eight. We've got an infraction here, non-releasing. Non-releasing of the offensive ball carrier. So it'll be a kick for touch by St. Martin. That'll go out on the 30, and it will be St. Martin's throw in the lineup. Nice clean take for St. Martin. Oh, wow, just about a take from the hard charging number 10. But back 10, tap and go from the 10 on St. Martin. Number 8 comes in tight. St. Martin threatening at the 10-meter line. Down to the 5. Remains at the 5. Looks like we have a non-release on the offensive player against St. Martin. So we'll be seeing kick to touch most likely from Lasalette. That will be Lasalette's lineout at the 25. Overshot throw caught by number 3 at the end. Thirteen crashing in the centers. Again, we have non-releasing against number 13. Hard barging run by number 11 results in the first try of the game. Score will be 5-0 for St. Martin. Conversion pending. conversion slightly left. The score remained 5-0 for St. Martin. St. Martin takes it on the side, comes back inside to the middle. Tries to switch the field of play. We got a forward pass called. That'll be scrummed down to Lassalette at the 25-yard line. You got an 8-man pick off the back of the scrum. 8-man takes it inside the 5-meter line. Good quick ruck by Lassalette. Number 7's held up. Gain lines pushed backwards, but Lassalette maintains possession. Got a ruck infraction in there. And you'll have St. Martin defending off the penalty right on the try line. Over to the prop inside. St. Martin's continues to play solid defense off the edge at the pillar and post. Coming out to the backs. Nice tackling by St. Martin on the standoff. Also the fly half for some. We have a poach by St. Martin inside that critical defensive zone. St. Martin takes it out beyond the 22-meter line for the first time in about a minute or so. Chip up and over. Got line out to St. Martin at about the 46-yard line. Hard run by the 12. Offloads inside. I think we're going to have a ruck infraction, perhaps a sealer not releasing on the tackle. Number 10 off to number 11. Back to 10. And we have a change of fortune as St. Martin comes down inside the 10-meter line. An injury on the field. It is officials timeout. While we're waiting, if there's any coaches or players from any of the teams that have already eaten, the barbecue folks have reached out and said they are willing to give seconds. So if you are a coach, player, or trainer for one of the teams, please head up above if you're still hungry. They're willing to give you seconds. They have some food left for you. So again, please head up there immediately. Please say a small prayer for the wellness of this player on the field. I believe it's number 8 for Lassalette. Give them a hand, folks. Often it's getting winded in those situations, and it does not feel good. I'm glad to see him up and walking off the field on his own. Thank you to the training staff for assisting. We'll just get an indication from the sir where we'll do the restart here. Looks like we're heading for a scrum at the 15. That will be St. Martin's scrum. Good hands there on a tough pass. Number 10 takes it down inside the 5-meter line. Back out to the center, we get a bit of a skip pass. Onto the 2-meter line. St. Martin's ball with the ruck. Great defense. Holding up that ball carrier as he crosses over the try line, pushing him back. We have the try scored, however. St. Martin puts one in the middle. Conversion to come. Great effort by both teams, both on the offensive and defensive sides of that set of phases. Score currently is 10-0 for St. Martin, but we'll see in a second where we are with the conversion. Conversion is good. Score 12-0, St. Martin, and they'll be receiving the kickoff momentarily. Time on the clock, 7:42 in the first half. I think the sir was not quite ready for that kick to take place, so I think we're probably going to end up redoing that one as there's conversation with the training staff. All right, here we go. It's a deep kick, fielded, interestingly, by St. Martin in the try zone. That will be a scrum down, La Salette. Salette with a clean take. Back 10, penalty against St. Martin for a ruck infraction. Ball's on about the 6-meter line right now. Pick up by number 7. Again, it'll remain around the 5 or 6. High out to the fly half. Tough pass off the leg there. Good tackling. Looks like there's a turnover in the tackle. Number 11 gets up, not in the grasp on the tackle. Still able to play. Back 10 against St. Martin, not releasing the ball offensively. Good hustle at the point of contact by La Salette. Number 5 takes it 12 meters. Off the penalty, tap and go. Another penalty. Tap and go again. Not quite as successful as the last one. Get out to the backs here. See if somebody can go for a run. Number 12 takes it to the sidelines. Counter ruck. Unsuccessful. Good run by the hooker. Salette now inside the 22, now threatening in that critical zone. Ball carrier rolled over, presenting the ball, and you have a poach by St. Martin. That turnover allows St. Martin to try to get themselves out of this zone. Good offload and contact, and you have St. Martin getting it out past the 30. Quick recycling, quick pickoff off the back of the ruck. Dump to number 11. Pushes off the player, going for a run. Shoulder barge prevents the tackle. You have number 11 into the try zone, and it's a score for St. Martin. That all started, if you recall, inside their own 22 on defense with a quality poach. Turn it into an offensive run and score. The score now 17-0 for St. Martin. With a convert attempt coming up. Congratulations to St. Martin with their counter-rucking. That's really served them well for possession, particularly in that critical series. That one is good. The score now will be 19-0 for St. Martin. And La Salette will be kicking off to St. Martin with 1:20 left in the half. Again, if there's anybody else, team members or coaches training staff. If you'd like to get more to eat, please go up to see the folks at the barbecue station. Nice high kick, taken in the centers. Number 13, breaking several tackles before one brought down. Yeah. We have a high tackle that'll be back 10 against La Salette. We've got 22 seconds left, and the lineout will come back to St. Martin on the 15. Cleanly taken off the tap. Play will continue. Time is on the field with the sir. St. Martin inside the 10-meter line now at about the 9. Down to the 5. Gets it with some space. A little backwards dump on the 1. St. Martin maintains possession with about 2 meters to go. And it is a try on the pickoff on the back of the row. No time left, but we will have the conversion. The sir is saying that the time is out, half is over. We will not get the convert attempt. So score at halftime is 19-0. Sorry, so it will be 24-0 for St. Martin. We're blessed to have a sunny day. I think most of us from all the locations can say this is one of the best rugby days we've had on a weekend for a while. Second half will start with a kick from La Salette to St. Martin. Score 24-0, St. Martin. Just waiting for the sir. Number 12, good deep kick. Coverage provided back there by La Salette. The 12 gets down to make the tackle. And we have a poach and steal. St. Martin ends up with the ball inside the 22. Inside the 5. Little pop over the top. The back in the corner with a straight arm. And I believe you have a forward drop. And it will be a scrum down, unless it was inside the try zone. It'll be a kick, as it was inside the try zone. Free kick. Pop back into the hands of number 9. St. Martin's gets another chance. Little chip outside to the winger. Oh, at his fingertips. That was a knock-on off those fingertips. The sir calls. That will be a scrum down for La Salette on their 9-meter line. Anticipate we'll probably get a scrum and a kick here, I think, anticipating the next move. There's the kick. Comes across pretty shallow, but picked up by the La Salette player. Bobbles and unfortunately tackled out of bounds. So that will be a line out to St. Martin at the 25-26 yard line. Looks like we're going with a 3-man line out. Sir with some instructions, and it will be a scrum. No. He's penalizing, likely for an offside infraction. There's a tap and go from La Salette. Runs into a covey of St. Martin players. And there is in that a poach and turnover for St. Martin. Nice offload and contact. St. Martin takes it up the side. Through the hands of one player, but fortunately into the hands of another. Pick and go by number 17. Number 9 keeps. 8-man picks, brings it close. I think we're about the 2 or 3 meter line. And you have the try scored by number 17. Big tough run in there by a few of the forwards and by the number 9 who set that up. That makes the score 29-0 for St. Martin with the outside conversion coming. And a conversion is good. St. Martin back with the ball. We have just a hair touch on the touchline. That'll be La Salette. Lasalette's lineout. Looks like it'll be a full lineout for Lasalette. Had a potential steal there, but they couldn't gather it in. We have an offside against St. Martin. It's Lasalette's ball. Lasalette chooses to run it to 13. Tough ball to manage coming into the feet of the fly half. We get a diving over, we get a ceiling infraction on the ruck against St. Martin. That'll be a penalty awarded to Lasalette. Good line break, but a little bit of a bobbled pass attempt, ends up in the hands of St. Martin. Good tough run on the outside. St. Martin brings it down to the inside the 22 meter. Off the tackle, the ball bounces off the floor, ends up in the hands of Lasalette. Penalty awarded, and then a quick tap and go ends up with a try for St. Martin. That'll make the score 41-0. Conversion pending. The conversion is good, making the score 43-0, and St. Martin will again set up to receive the kickoff. 16:30 on the clock. Number 10 for Lasalette, set up with the drop kick. Nicely struck, high ball makes it to inside the 20. Kick back by St. Martin with a lucky bounce back. At pace, this looks like it could be another score. Right in the middle. Touchdown with flair, and that is another try on the board, making it 48-0. Sometimes the rugby gods are with you on those bounces, and we certainly saw it on that bounce back to the at-pace player. Short little chip shot is good. And we've passed the half century mark here. St. St. Martin will be back to receive with 14:40 left in the game. Some double moves in there. Anyway, ended up in an infraction and penalty. Tap and go to the number one. Back 10 again on the ruck infraction. Not releasing in the tackle. Tap up to the backs. Ran out of space. That'll be a line out to St. Martin at the 24-yard line. We have the three-man line. Beautifully executed. Got a line out infraction. Player's probably set up in the wrong position. 13 takes it in for La Salette. So Martin is hard on the counter ruck right now. Unfortunate knock on for number 10. Oh, it's got an offside play first. So La Salette's ball on the penalty inside the 22. 13 with a hard run. Coached by number 8. Pick up by number 17. He's got help outside here. Number 10. St. Martin. With the offloads in contact, work it down to the opposite side of the 22. That'll be a dangerous play. Anytime you see a player's feet go above his shoulders, that will result in a card. We have 11 minutes and 3 seconds left. Leslie kicks a touch that'll end up at the 27 or so yard line and will be Lassalette's throw in. Number 9 was good to gather that up and get it out to his backs. Some space out there for number 15. Got some space to scamper. Tackle by the collar. That will be considered a high tackle. Because the danger it is to the player to be tackled in that manner. So quick tap and go. Lassalette. At around the five. Oh, pushback on the game line. Lassalette struggled inside the 10-meter today. Had several opportunities. See if they can wrap this up with some score. Good tough running by number four. Gets them down to the 3-meter or so. He should have it in the corner. Number 21. Try is scored. Lassalette shows some determination and puts some points on the board with 8:37 left and a conversion to come. Well struck, certainly at the distance, but tough angle, and the convert is not good, so it'll be 50-5 with 7:55 left. That is always a challenging position. St. Martin will kick the Lassalette as we enter into the last 7.5 minutes of the game. Deep kick from St. Martin, fielded on the 2-meter line. Kick for space. That will result in a knock-on as it came off the chest. That'll be scrum down Lassalette at their own 44-meter line. We'll redo that scrum with the collapse. It will remain at last. Let's put in. Looks like we're playing without an 8-man at this time for both teams. That's why you saw the equalization sending the man out to the backs. Put in is clean. Last leg gets the ball. Solid tackle by St. Martin. And up and over. Taken cleanly this time. Oh, oh. He's got it. He's got it, Ben. The referee plays advantage. He's going to come back to the high tackle over here. He was playing advantage for St. Martin. There was no advantage gained. It'll be a high tackle and a penalty to the benefit of St. Martin. Kicker finds touch. We have 4:28 left in the game. Give or take a little bit, depending on what the sir has on his watch. That'll be St. Martin's throw-in. Looks like they'll go with a three-man lineout. It's been very effective for them. Substitution here. Number 17 returns from the sin bin. We'll pop back to number 8, but he's not unable to walk the line. And that'll be Lassalette's lineout. Lassalette elects to go with the 7-man line. Nice clean take from Lassalette. Solid run by the fullback. Number 12 splits position and able to take it, but unfortunately 21, again, unable to get off the line or get the ball away before he's across the line. So that'll be line out to St. Martin. Nice steal off the high pass. Lassalette's ball. Hard tackle pushes the gain line back. There we go, moving it forward again. Got a known release against Lassalette. That will be on the ball carrier. What a quick take to the outside. St. Martin's able to stay inside. Over to number 17. He's back in the play. And St. Martin is able to get it down in the corner with 1:05 left. That'll make it 55-5 with the convert to come. Again, reminder, everyone is welcome at Mass inside the chapel. That will be happening immediately following the man of match presentations that'll be down field side. So after this match, please join us for the man of the match presentations. And then we'll head to Mass in the chapel. All the teams have eaten at this point, but if there's anybody who would like extra food as far as team members, coaches, etc., please head up and grab some of that additional food, please. Also, tomorrow morning, we have St. Martin versus Father Ryan at 10 a.m., St. Thomas Aquinas versus Lassalette at 11:30 a.m., and 1 p.m. we have SLUH versus Chaminade. That's tomorrow on this field. We will also have some JV action at 10 and 11:30. So would love to see everybody again tomorrow. And hopefully, I think it's supposed to be even a better day than today. Time is on the field with the serve. Little box kick from St. Martin. Fielded by number 25. Number 15 takes it out wide. Sir looks like he's playing advantage for La Salette. Advantage arm is still up. Chip straight up. Advantage may have been over. Oh. We have back 10 against St. Martin. Off the feet in the ruck. Again, you have to support your own weight. At all times, well engaged in a ruck. Failure to do so will result in a penalty. Unfortunate bounce inside of that ruck, comes out the side. St. Martin picks up the ball on that turnover. And kick for touch could be the end. That is the end of our first day of the All-Catholic Rugby Festival here at St. Louis University High School. Thank you to all the teams for your participation, coaches. And let's also hear it for the officials, both of the sirs who did a great job today. And did a lot of running. You think the players are tired? Those gentlemen in orange and green did a great job, and they put on a lot of miles, so thank you to them. Again, following this match, we're going to have a picture with the two teams. Please also make sure that you stick around for the Men of the Match presentations and then for the Mass in the St. Louis University High School Birchman's Chapel. If you need assistance, I'll be outside trying to make sure people can find their way. And it would be helpful if the...